Welcome back to our Mayfair gallery. I'm Charis Tyndall from Charles Ede. In front of me, I have a collection of Shabtis. Now, Shabtis were little figurines that the Egyptians buried with them to perform their duties in the afterlife. The word Shabti literally means answerer, and the deceased would have one of these so that when Osiris said to him, come and plow the fields or you know, till the soil, whatever it was, their Shabti would come along to do all of their agricultural work. The reason why they're in this form, they're in the mummy form, which is the form that you were buried in, I think we're all familiar with the term, but what they have on them in their hands is they're almost always shown with, and certainly for the late period, which is where these faience ones are from, 7th to 4th century BC, they have a crook, a flail, a seed bag, some kind of agricultural implement that would help them perform these tasks. Now, they vary hugely in size and quality and material from stone, wood, or faience. The richer you were, the finer the quality of the sculpture. These were made by being pushed. It was like a quartz sand-based material that was pushed into a mold. And the really fine ones were then finished by hand and carved. So examples such as this one of Nefer Ibresarnith is unbelievably fine, and you can see it's been meticulously carved to show the details of the striations of the beard, the little cosmetic lines of the eyes, you know, even down to fingernails on the hands. It's really remarkable. And the hieroglyphs themselves were also finished by hand, especially for these much higher quality ones. You get other examples where they're painted on, or this New Kingdom wood Shabti, which doesn't have any of them on at all. Now, the example here of Nefer Ibresarnith was discovered in 1929 by Cecil Firth. There were 336 of these Shabtis found at the tomb of Nefer Ibresarnith in Saqqara. And because of the unbelievably high quality of them, often known to be of the highest quality of the period that you can find, many of these have ended up in all of the major museums around the world, but there are still some, a fair few, that can be found on the private market. This one is in really good condition. The quality of the glaze is still fantastic. It's bright, it has this very attractive green hue to it. Other examples are slightly bluer or slightly more intense with the green. What's really good about the Shabtis of Nefer Ibresarnith and knowing exactly where they were found is that we've learnt more about the individual from what was written on the walls of his tomb. So he was actually the Wab priest, or the royal chancellor at the palace of the pharaoh. Indeed, his name Nefer Ibre was the same as one of the names of Samtek II, and that's why we're able to date quite clearly when this man was alive. It was a very specific and important role that he had. To be a Wab priest, you had to be ritually pure and clean. You had to wash twice in the day and twice nightly in cold water. You had to shave every hair from your body, and then your mouth had to be washed out in natron. It was a detergent used in laundry and also used in the mummification process. I can imagine it was absolutely vile. And once you were ritually pure, it meant that he was allowed to be in the presence of the god. So he was clearly a very important man, and it's no surprise that he ended up with what is often considered the finest Shabtis of the period. Now, these Shabtis that we currently have in the gallery range in price from £5,000 up to £60,000, and are intriguing either as single statues or highly evocative as a group.